A quick word about the mathematics of this equation of ours, or most specifically the natural log of A divided by A0 activity now divided by activity as it was in the past. Let's look at which of these radioactive isotopes would be the best if I am not looking for a 5,300-year-old skeletal remains. I'm looking at a bottle of 10-year-old Merlot. Bottle of 10-year-old red wine. Which of these would be the best to look at? Now, 10 years ago, when this bottle was sealed, I know what the activity was at that time, and I can certainly look at what the activity is today. Now, which of these would be best to use? And that relates to the mathematics of this equation. Carbon-14 is 5,730 years for a half-life for half of the of those carbon-14s to undergo beta-negative decay. So in only 10 years, very, very, very few of those would have decayed. So the activity 10 years ago versus activity now is almost exactly the same. So I'm going to be dealing here with a natural logarithm of 1. Seeing these two are going to be very close to each other. And the natural logarithm of 1 is 0. In other words, my time is going to show me a 0 time. On the other hand, if I look at oxygen 15, it's only 120 odd seconds. In other words, there'll be almost nothing left today. The activity today is almost going to be zero. And I'm looking at the natural logarithm of about zero divided by what it was at that time. And the natural logarithm, obviously, of zero is not defined. And as the natural logarithm of a number, if that number tends to zero, the natural logarithm of that is going to tend to negative infinity. So I'm going to get a time there of not zero, but infinite number of years. So the best one is going to be this tritium-3, hydrogen with two neutrons in the nucleus. And because that has an activity of round about the age of my wine. In other words, about half of them would have disappeared, and we know that delta T, the delta N divided by delta T, is proportional to how many there are now. So there is going to be a substantial difference between A and A0. And that will give me a nice fraction to get a natural logarithm of, with a negative value, to give me a good estimation of the time, of the age of that wine. So we choose, because we have this natural logarithm expression here, we have to choose dating the atom or molecule that we are using to date. We've got to choose it according to the half-life to give us a nice accurate answers as far as the age of our specimens are concerned. Good, let's cement our understanding of carbon dating, radioactive dating at least, by these three quick questions. Can carbon-14 dating be used for a wooden box? Yes, it can, if it was well-preserved wooden box, because that tree took in nutrients and carbon dioxide from the air for photosynthesis, and indeed we can use it for a golden box. Can we use it for a gold statue? No, we can't. That gold was never living, it never took in carbon. It has no carbon. It has a gold statue, will have no carbon. We can't use it. And for well-preserved animal fur, yes, what is fur? It's like hair. Hair contains a lot of hair contains a lot of carbon, keratin, and in other words, yes, you can use carbon-14. If carbon-14 to carbon-12 ratio was much more than the 1 to 8.3 times 10 to the power 11 thousands of years ago, would our estimation of T be there be too small or too large? Too small or too large? Well, remember we said A, activity was N divided by, or delta N divided by delta T, and that was proportional to N. That was proportional to N, the number I have. So if this ratio was much larger, 2 to that, or 3 to that, then n would have been higher. That means my activity then, that means activity 0 would have been much larger. If this was much larger, then this fraction is smaller, and that means t is too small. That means I'll underestimate the age of my sample, of my specimen, I should say. Now, can tritium be used for 700-year-old specimen? No, we said that tritium has a half-life of, I've forgotten now, we said it is a half-life of about 12 years. So certainly after 700 years, the activity today would be so low of my specimen now. That activity would be so enormously low. Every 12 years, I have half. There'll be nothing left. I'll have almost negligible activity today. That means I am taking the natural log of zero there, which is undefined. So I can really not use tritium, for an example, that is 700 years old. Good. Here we have a meteorite. We know that there is 93.8% of the mass of the original isotope still present. So somehow we know how much isotope there was versus how much there is now, and the mass that remains is 93.8% of that radioisotope. We calculate the age of this meteorite to be 4.51 times 10 to the power 9 years. What is the half-life of a radioisotope? So this is a convoluted problem, and all they're trying to do is just to see if you can do some algebra with the equations that you know. Is it a very realistic problem? Are you going to deal with it in a day-to-day life if you work with this sort of thing? No. Anyway, let's do it. Do we know an equation? Because that's the way I think, you know, that I look at this. What is an equation that we do know for half-life? Well, we know that the decay constant equals the natural log of 2 divided by the half-life. And that means the half-life is going to equal 0.693 divided by the decay constant. I don't know what the decay constant is, but I certainly know another equation that has the decay constant in it right there. So if I have n divided by n0, I take the natural log of that, that is going to be minus lambda t, and that's the age t, not the half-life t. In other words, lambda is going to be the natural log of, now do I know n divided by n0? Yes, I do, because the mass, 93.8% of the mass of the mass of the original isotope is still present. That means this is 0.938 as a fraction, 93.8% as a fraction is still left. So that is going to be that divided by negative t, and I can put that in over here for my lambda, which will make this the natural log of 0.938 times minus t there. This is a fraction, this is going to be negative, cancelling that negative up there, and that gives me a half-life of 4.88 times 10 to the power 10 years. Times 10 to the power 10 years. So it's a simple algebra problem. Do you know your equations? Can you play around with them to give you the half-life, knowing that the half-life is going to have something to do with the decay constant, knowing that the decay constant has something to do with the ratio of the amount you have now divided by that which it was. So in the end, quite easy to work out. Now this is our last problem in this section, but it's the most important probably. And you have to look at something very carefully. We have a specimen and it has 9.2 grams of carbon in total, and that 9.2 grams of carbon has an activity of 1.6 becquerel. So in 9.2 grams of carbon there's going to be a certain number of radioactive isotope, and that has an activity of 1.6 carbon-14 per second. What is the age of the specimen? Now, what we are going to take for granted is that over the last couple of thousand years, the living organism activity has been constant. And remember, this is the most important part of this problem. We estimated before 1 gram of carbon has an activity of 0.23 becquerel. Remember, we took 1 gram of carbon, we looked at, because we said it was something 8.3 times 10 to the power 11 carbon 12 to 1 carbon 14, and we worked it out what would be in 1 gram of a sample, how many there would be, and we worked out its activity. So in a 1 gram specimen, we'll get this. So what are we going to get in a 9.2 gram specimen? In a 9.2 gram, we'll get this divided by this times that, and that gives me, I think, 2.1 becquerel. So don't get confused where we got that 0.23. That 0.23 is per 1 gram. If I had 2 grams, more, there'd be double the amount of carbon-14s, so the carbon-14s per second activity would be double that. Okay, so 9.2 grams, we're going to get 2.1 becquerel activity. And now we know that time is going to equal the natural log of A, which is what it is now, or in our specimen 1.6, divided by what it's always been, 2.1. 2.1 times negative 0.693 divided by 5730 years. Okay, these, it's becquerel divided by becquerel, so there's nothing left as far as units are concerned. This is going to go into the numerator as years. This is the natural log of 2. So I can plug in, if I plug in years here, I get my answer in years, since nothing else has any units. I don't have to convert for seconds, I want my answer in years, and this gives me about 2,300 years if you plug those values, 2,300 years if you plug those values. And the important bit about this is, if it states that 9.2 grams has an activity of that, our initial 0.23 was for 1 gram. You have to convert that so you're working with the same size specimen as it was then versus what it is now. And we worked that out for living organism as it is now, but the now refers to activity of the specimen that we have now. This, what is in a living organism now, equals what it was for a living organism back then, A0. Which we just take for being the same over the last couple of thousand years, although it's not a correct statement in itself.